Let's get an update on the situation in quick hit Batanes. DZMM's Dennis Dato is there. He joins us by phone. Dennis, what's the development?
Hi, Sandy. Exactly 1 week after the quake hit Bayad Batanes, the bell rang out from the collapsed bell tower of Nuestra Senora del Rosario Parish Church around 5:30 in the morning. 68-year-old bell ringer Aurelia Ponce was unable to restrain her tears when she rang the bells. She said the sound of the bells gives them hope to recover from the tragedy. A mass was conducted in front of the damaged parish. Father Rolly Ulango reminded the people to just stay still amidst the calamities. He said unity will help them get through all the challenges. The people of Itbayat appeal for help to build the 18th century church. Father Ulango said many have already pledged to help for the reconstruction of their church. The holy structures will be rebuilt to its original form because it has been part of the identity of their hometown. Residents of Itbayat thank everyone who sends them help and assistance. They assure that they will recover from these tragedies. People now start to reassemble their houses despite the lack of materials. Supplies are still undelivered due to the bad weather conditions. Early Saturday, several aftershocks hit the town, but life continues for the people of Itbayat. Stanley.
Yes, Dennis. Most part of the country is being battered by heavy rains. So what's the weather like in Batanes right now, and how is this affecting perhaps the arrival of relief goods?
Well, it's the weather condition here in Bayat since morning is very hot, Stanley, and it does not affect the relief and recovery operations here in Bayat.
Thank you for watching. Now, for more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.